Suppose you look up here in the blackboard, in the whiteboard, and this is a candle, the candle, and the candle is emitting light and heat in many directions. And this candle may take 5 hours, 7 hours to burn to the end, right? And after all the wax is gone, it's like the candle dies. You think that the candle will go somewhere after it dies? The candle has something like 5 hours to live, to burn. And do you think that after it has burned to the end, it goes somewhere or not? And you, do you think that this is the end of the candle? This line is the line of the end of the candle? There is a candle from here up here. I agree. You agree. We all agree that from this line up, there is a candle. But do you think that from this line down, there is no candle? No or yes? It seems that as you are a Buddhist, you have to believe that there is something after you die. And if you are a Christian also, you have to believe that after you die, there's something that will go somewhere. In the candle, in the case of the candle, do you think that there is something left after the candle has burned itself completely? Who said? Yes. Not too many. Who said no? There's no more candle after. Many people are not decided. The Dhamma is very deep and lovely. We have to learn to learn with all our heart in order to really understand. The question, where shall we go after we die, is a good question. But without practice, looking very, very deeply, we cannot have a good answer. Look at this candle. In this moment, this is the present moment. This line is the present moment. In this present moment, the candle is already going somewhere. Because in this very moment, the candle is sending itself in many directions in terms of heat and light. So the candle is going in this very moment. It does not need to arrive here in order to go somewhere. You the same. You are the same. In this very moment, you are going somewhere. There is a coming and going that happens in every moment of your daily life. And you go A little bit like the candle. The candle goes in terms of light and heat. And you go in terms of thought, speech, and physical movement. Three kinds of action. Every moment of your daily life, you are offering thinking, speaking, and acting. And you go in many directions. Speech, you go into your children. Anything you think, anything you speak, anything you act, you go to your children, and to your friends, and to the cosmos. And that is called karma, action. We are spending ourselves, we are going. I live my daily life in such a way that I can go beautifully into the world, into my disciples, into my friends. I want to think beautiful thoughts, the thoughts of loving kindness, the thought of compassion, the thought of understanding, the thought of love. And every time I have a thought, I offer myself to you, to my disciple, to my friend, and to the world. That is going. That's my continuation. And I don't want to offer the negative things. I want to transform the negative things so that they become positive before I go, because I will enter into the cosmos, and the closest are my friends, my disciples. So when you look into my disciples, you can see me. When you look into my friends, you can see me. And this is very scientific. I continue to go into my disciples and to my friends and to the cosmos. You can see me outside of my body. And this is my practice. The candle does the same, you see. The candle is offering light and heat. And the light is offered to the world, the heat is offered to the world, but the light and heat is offered to the candle by itself. The light of candle can light the candle. And the heat of the candle can cause the wax to melt. And it is because like that the wick can absorb the wax, so the flame can be powerful. So any action made by the candle affect the world and affect itself. Any action come out from the candle goes back to the candle also. When you have a thought of loving kindness, the world profit and you profit also. The effect is immediate. When you say something very nice to another person, you offer that person receive, has an effect on that person, and you also profit from that loving speech. Or any action of yours can affect the world and affect yourself. And some action, some thought, some speech come back to you right away in this very moment. But sometime a thought or a word would need more time in order to come back to you. You say something not true. That speech affect you right away, now. But later on, it will go back to you. And people discover that it's a lie. So that goes back to you, and you have to bear the effect of that. The things that we do now, but we had to suffer 10 years later or 20 years later. So the karma, it means the action can have two kinds of effect, immediate effect and retarded effect. It's like some medicines. When you swallow the medicine, it will release some substance and it has effect now, but later on it will continue to affect you. So your thinking, your speech, and your act affect you right away, but later on will continue to affect you. So suppose here, in the present moment, you do something, or you say something very strong. It go out of the world and affect the world, and it go back right in and affect yourself. But some action will go back to you later on, and that candle has to burn until this line in order to receive the retribution. In Vietnamese, we say. Cha ăn mặn thì con khát nước. The father eats very salty, and the son has to drink a lot of water. So whatever you do, you think and you speak now will have an effect right now and will have effect later on. And suppose you do something very strong. And you get have an effect. Yeah. If your son will have to get the retribution, because your son is your continuation. Your son is the most visible retribution. Your son is the most visible continuation of yours. Your daughter. Your daughter is the most, one of the most visible continuation of yours. And it is you, your son is you, your daughter is you, your disciple is you, your friends is you, because you have been going to them every day. So I can see my continuation not only in this body, in this consciousness, but I can see my continuation in my disciple, in my friends, and in the world. You see, I have written a number of books. And some of my books go very, very far. And it is affecting the people who are reading. I have offered many wholesome thought, many insight in my books. And some of the books go into prison. Into the prisons, and prisoners have been reading and practicing, and I am in prison because I like to be in prison in order to be helpful. So there are many prisoners who are my continuation, and there are Catholic monks and Catholic nuns who live in cloisters, and they have read my book, and they have written letters to me. They were able to release some of their views. They feel much lighter, and I am continued by them. So I can see me continued in many forms. So when at this point, when you don't see my body anymore, you say that Thầy is no longer there. That's not true. Thầy is there, but you have to got the eyes of sightlessness in order to recognize him. It's like when the cloud has become rain, the cloud is not lost, and you can recognize the cloud in her new form, the rain. So when you don't see Thầy in this form anymore, you can recognize Thầy's presence, Thầy's continuation in other forms. And the most visible is his disciples. Look at the monks, the nuns, and the lay practitioners in Plum Village, you can see Thai. It's not very difficult. The way they walk, the way they smile, the way they cook, the way they sweep the ground, the way they help other people. There's a lot of Thai in Thai. So the question is, can be answered like this. If you know where you are going in this moment, there will be no difficulty in knowing where you go after you die. You are dying and you are being reborn right here and right now in this very moment. You don't need to arrive at this point in order to die. You are dying in every moment and you are being reborn in every moment, not only inside of yourself, but also outside. We know that there are many cells in the body. And the cells in our body, many cells in our body die every moment. In this very moment, many cells in us die in order to make room for other cells to be born. So birth and death happen right here and right now. You don't need to arrive at the age of 80 in order to die. You are dying now in order for you to be born now. Birth and death are happening in every moment. That is the teaching of the Buddha, and you have to practice looking deeply in order to see that. So when you say after I die, you mean that now you are not dying. That's not true. You are dying in this very moment, and you are being born right in this moment. Suppose death happened in every moment. Many millions cells die in this very moment. Every time someone dies, we organize funerals and we cry. But if every time a cell in our body dies, and if we organize funerals and cry, and then we have no time to do anything, no time left to do anything at all. Practice looking deeply in order to see that. So when you say after I die, you mean that now you are not dying. That's not true. You are dying in this very moment, and you are being born right in this moment. Suppose death happened in every moment. Many millions cells die in this very moment. Every time someone dies, we organize funerals and we cry. But if every time a cell in our body dies, and if we organize funerals and cry, and then we have no time to do anything, no time left to do anything at all. You have to accept birth and death that happen in us every moment. So in order to answer this question, you have to practice looking deeply the way the Buddha proposed, so that you can see that birth and death are happening in every moment, and you are reborn in every moment, not only in your body and your consciousness, but in other forms as well. We continue, because this question is so demands a lot of looking deeply.